I'm gonna continue being me, nigga. Like, I'm gonna continue being the man that I'm supposed to be. If you're not pulling your own weight, or if you're not throwing your hat in the ring and saying, yo, fuck that old nigga, we over here. If you're not doing that, if you're not claiming your seat at the fucking table, no one's gonna give it to you, bro.
I done did the autograph thing, my man damn is blessed to hop on the bus. But the boy who did the drill thing, I did the real thing, no niggas is sus.
Come on, give me a second! I just want to go to
come
on. I need to go to the car. Yo! The two guys are recording, I
said,
I'm going to go to
It's different now. This is where everyone gets to shine by executing and being on 1,000 in every fucking little thing that they do that has to do with this pie.
Hello, kilo. My name is Roy.
This is Juice Peggy.
DJ Mr. X.
Why is it does it? Kana.
Hi, I'm Tolo.
My name is Temba.
D Gobs.
But found by KO 2019, top of 2019, where they saw a song of mine called Snooze 2. And then I guess from there they say the rest is history.
Late 2017, we spoke about Jay. He told me about his whole vision about his kind of world and what he's doing with Tolu and how I can be involved with it and try and make it thicker and grounded, you know, with a good foundation.
It's crazy how I became part of the label. It was sometime last year, 2020. Remember, 2020 was crazy for a lot of artists. So a lot of things were crazy. Things were going down. But my life just actually changed. Really, I mean, I changed when I got a hit up from this kind of, they're like, yo, dude, we see potential in you. We'd love to link up and just talk to you. We linked up, had a meeting. The guys wanted me to join the label. I didn't even think about it that much. I was like, Yazin, let's do it.
Before the kind of whole thing, it was a transition to kind of a form caster. I was road managing the Jeds, my E, Mugs, and that's how I met most of the guys. When everything was official, KO and Tolu called me and were like, hey, you wanna have you this kind of world to be part of the team, you know? We had a meeting, everything was on paper, and everything made sense to me. Hence I'm here today.
My manager Deso, shout out Deso Banks. He hit me up one day, told me, yo, you gotta go meet some label managers, right? And I'm thinking, it's just gonna be a comfortable sit-in, like just talk to people. But nah, they had the whole idea of bringing me onto the team.
Come on.
I'm guessing!
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Namaj. Namaj.
Namaj.
Back in 2019, towards the end of the year, I was about to leave. I was still at university. And then the Jets were telling me that just getting labeled. We've done this before with Cash Time, and I sort of would I like to come join the team and then let's see what we can do. Rest of Tulu and KO. And so, joined up in November 2018. Yeah. And still here.
I mean, everyone is dope, you know. And that's why we chose these guys to work with. Everyone is different, you know, and very talented, you know, a lot of potential. I mean, I feel like it's obviously still early days in the label, like it's still fairly new, you know. I mean, we started the label properly just when, literally when COVID kicked in.
I say yes because I'm way better off than where I was initially, you know? Way better off than that. There's been a lot of growth in my career, like a lot of growth, because if I look at it now, or if we do the math, it's a little over a year where, because I'll take it from section, because that's when my debut started, you know? So that was last year, March. So it's been like a little over a year, you know? So if I take that into consideration, I mean, I've done a lot, because a lot has been done.
Yeah, I think it is. I think it is. Yeah, it's good. Everything, I feel like everything in life starts slow. You can't just and just fly. You need to understand that everything is slow. So me, I love where I'm going. I love where I'm going. My people love my music. So I'm happy. I think we're still going to do crazier things.
On the most honest part, it is, right? Because I don't think people know where we started, right? How we came to be where we are today. The projection is beautiful. I'm very grateful, yeah. I think I'm on the right path.
For me personally, I just think like, in terms of push, you know, it's not enough. In terms of push, not enough, because when my song dropped, I want to talk about my song specifically, when my song dropped, I didn't feel like it was pushed enough, you know? I didn't reach other avenues, other biggest radio stations. My song didn't get to play at the biggest radio stations besides, Metro FM. You know, my song wasn't there on 5 FM, it wasn't on Cozy FM. So for me, that's a bit of a letdown, you know? It discouraged me. Somehow, I felt like they were lacking. You know, I didn't do some shows, I couldn't do live amp, I couldn't do, you know, your massive music shows. I couldn't do a lot of TV shows to push my song.
I feel if the label could be more inclusive in how we move from Monday to Friday, and it's not like Monday I'm out there, Tuesday I'm out there, but there's a set plan on what are we doing from beginning to the end.
Improvement, yeah. I think gigs for me, I love being on stage. I think if we can gig more, I'll be happy.
Because everyone is different, everyone comes with different challenges, you know? So it's just a matter of trying to understand everyone as an individual and treating everyone equally, you know? Cause it's like everyone becomes like your kids and you can't really have like the favorite, you know? So it's just having to just have a balance between all of that, you know? But obviously, whoever is eager more than the other will succeed. It's just how it is, you know? But I mean, we just love everyone the same.
With an indie, I knew what I was getting myself into because I've done indie with the same gents, but now things were different. The environment, the atmosphere was different. The people were different, everything was new. But the different parts I can say from a major to an indie, it's budget, in all honesty. And with a major label, there's also a red tape of when you wanna get crazy ideas that you wanna do and what's on that. And with an indie, there's not a red tape, but the only red tape is a budget.
Yeah, I done did the autograph team, my man damn is blessed to hop on the bus. And a boy who did the drill thing, I did the real thing, no niggas is sus.
Very grateful for where they've put my career as an entertainer, like solo, the solo act. I've built a nice, good rapport. My first song was one of the biggest cats in the country. It's not every day niggas like just at the gate get that whole image done for them. So I'm very grateful for that and teaching me the knowledge behind being the artist, not just more so being the rapper, but everything it takes to be a polished and a good artist that brands can work with, other artists can work with, and the knowledge that I've gained, I'm really grateful for that. And as we keep going, I'm really grateful for that.
Structure-wise, kind of what is on point. I think the team has a structure right now. Everything is on point. there's Gobs, there's Tulu, you know, and there's KO, who's making sure that the music is on point. There's Gobs, who's making sure the artists are on point. There's Tulu, who's making sure that the finances and everything just sticks together.
They've done a lot, especially for me. You know, they've done a lot, growing me from just a brand to taking me to the top. You know, having a big song now, it's quite amazing. I'd like to applaud them on that. You know, with Baqhubeka and to work hard for all of us. You know, because as much as us, we wanna see us at the top, and we also need to put in the work as artists. We must meet them halfway. But for that, they've been doing great.
With the year going and seeing how serious we're gonna have to like really play for us to achieve the mission that we set out for ourselves, it was important for us to go back to the drawing board and just be real with ourselves and be like, wait, that's no different from what we did last year.
So we are late. We are waiting for KO. Always.
I'd say the best, or maybe one of the best decisions that I have taken just to improve the whole structure of the label is, one, getting a person like Temba to come on board to assist with, you know, taking the music to radio stations and to TV, you know, and so forth, and just being able to, because I mean, with the relationships that he's had before he joined Skanda, they assist a lot, you know. So I think that has helped for the structure. And another big one was us taking on board Gobs, you know, Manqoba Sishi, as a label manager, to just like oversee the whole label, you know. And it has taken obviously a lot of stress off our shoulders in terms of now having a direct interaction every day with artists. You know, I know that he has all of that covered, you know, and it has really helped in terms of getting everyone in shape, you know, with also helping with managing time and everything. So I think that was a really dope investment for us.
Man, time management can be the biggest problem, especially for the older cats, you know, the more experienced cats, you know, the KOs, the Ma'is, you know, it can be a bit of a slip to be coaching those guys. But, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do so that the ones that are coming behind them can see that time is something that goes a long way. It's almost in entertainment, it's 50% of the battle won.
More music from Just Baby. More videos too.
It starts off with the artists that we have on our roster already. I want to see their lives flip 180, you know? Wherever it is that they are in their lives right now, as men and as artists, I want to see them rise and elevate, you know? That can only escalate and grow Skanda World as a label to greater heights.
There's going to be some changes in the label, and I'm excited about them. Very excited. I can't wait. I think, in all honesty, I don't think there's going to be any independent label that will compare to us. Yeah, we want to do some amazing things. This new music, which sounds amazing. My plan is to, hey man, push the culture forward with the label and the chat.
More growth, because I feel like now it's still to a certain degree step one for me, you know. So I feel like 2022 is step two.
I just want to drop music. I just want to drop a lot of music. I want to drop smashes. I just want to take over, you know. For me as a brand, as DJ Mr. X, I just want to fuck shit up. You know, there's a lot coming that I've planned, with the team. So I just want to drop a lot of music, grow my brand, play where I couldn't play before, you know? Travel, yeah.
Man, my E being on top, man. I think my E is gonna be the biggest thing in the South African music industry as a whole, you know? Entertainment industry, you know? I'm gonna be a very, like, the biggest inspiration next year in 2022.
What's up? Yeah. I'm coming for the gas like Cecil. No Metro Police on the back row. Skish, skish, skit, what's the level? You the one on the high. You the only one on my temple, East Angel. By the time I pull up, don't...
If at least everyone can have a project that drops next year, that would be amazing for us, you know? It's going to be a lot of work, but we definitely up for the challenge. I think we have the team. And we, you know, making all the necessary steps to also have partners as well, you know, that we want to join forces with so we can achieve all of that. So I'm looking forward to that.
2022 is going to be a big year for Scandalworld. You know, firstly, the artists are dropping bodies of work. You know, it's going to be crazy. The citizens must go out there and support. It's going to be a big year full of a lot of content. What the citizens want, the citizens will get in 2022, and may they support us all the way to the top.
My name is Ndwanano, I'm a Scandal citizen. I've been a fan specifically of KO, that's the Cash Time. So when they started the Scandalworld movement a few years back, I had to transact with him because I've been following him for the past 15 years.
This is Given. I'm a Scandal citizen. What drew me to a Scandalworld movement is watching KO's life. Even if he gets setbacks every time, he manages to bounce back. So I love that.
As a Scandal citizen, we have a WhatsApp group where we've created early last year, where we talk about everything in relation to Big Planet, about the artist and the movement. So, we had a frustration at the beginning of the year in terms of the rollout, where we thought our artists, the new artists specifically, Loki and Roy, were not releasing as much as music. So we decided to write an email to the camp to request them to say, from the outside, we felt like the guys are not releasing a lot of music. So we wanted them to release music and also videos. For instance, in terms of Loki, Loki joined the camp last year, but he only released two singles, the whole 2020, if I'm not mistaken, Section and Fireman.
We love what the group does by opening doors for youngins. So our concern is that the Scandalworld Twitter page is not consistent when it comes to posting. So promoting their music, it's not like on top of their game.
When that email dropped, I was like, fuck. Zanyalezi, man. You know, I was like boiling, you know? And then I just took a deep breath, and we have our weekly status meetings, you know, Scandalworld management and directors. And we just rounded up, you know, I shared the mail. We just sat down and we found the best way to respond to the citizens, you know, because we understood that it's coming from a place of love and, you know, passion. These guys are really passionate and they really love what we do, you know, so they're part of the family.
Thick, thick. Click, click. Dick pics.
I don't think they really understand, obviously, behind the scenes, you know, they're fans. They just want what they want and, you know, that's really how I felt about the email when it came in. You know, I was really like frustrated, but you know, we calmed down, we took our time and we responded accordingly.
I want to see your lives change. I want to see niggas changing their families' lives, because this is what this shit is about.
What's me saying? The bottom of my fish is me saying. Like a little fish is me saying. Thank God, but she turned into a stalker. I will can do see sus me say it. Dingagit. Possessive ngale pola lingagit. Say la shim lens and hobby dollar lingagit. Dingagit. Bakuzin, Bakuzin, guns all over zingagit.